special diet in arthritis. See, this is what happened when a couple come to me for treatment. It's invariably, suppose if the male husband has got an arthritis, poor girl, the girl, the lady, the wife is so concerned about her husband. She tell me, what diet to take? What diet should I give my husband? I tell her, you can give her anything except your cooking. That's the only thing I can tell. Or if the maid, nowadays most of the husbands cook at home, so I think they can continue to cook and eat better food also. I don't do anything at home, I'm extremely sorry. There is no special diet for arthritis. But take a well-balanced, nutritious diet. That's very important. You go into the internet, you will have million answers for diet and arthritis. Some people will say avoid dairy products. Some people will say take lacto-vegetarian diet. Some people will say you take selenium antioxidants. There are so many theories and so many papers published on diet and arthritis. But one important fact is a well-balanced, nutritious diet. And coming down to our country, our food is rich in antioxidants, natural food rich in antioxidants, which help arthritis. Turmeric also is a very good one. In fact, you see people, especially with the COVID coming on the horizon, everybody started looking forward to alternate therapy, and they found wonderful substances available in the food discovered by our forefathers. In fact, even turmeric capsules are available. So there is no special diet, nutritious diet. If you are taking painkillers, you will have to take a bland food, no spicy food at all. Any surgical procedure to be done for arthritis? Yes. If the hip is destroyed, the knee is destroyed, the shoulder is destroyed, then ultimately they have to go in for a joint replacement. Now, joint replacement, every joint is replaced in this country. And I had a wonderful experience with my orthopedic colleagues after joint replacement. They walk, in fact, the patients definitely walk better than I. So don't get frightened. No phobia for getting joints replaced at all. Just get it out. It's a myth. Is arthritis hereditary? This is an important question people ask me. Doctor, I have rheumatoid arthritis. Will my child get rheumatoid arthritis? There are certain diseases in which there is a genetic predisposition, but majority of the diseases do not have a genetic predisposition at all. Genetic predisposition to going to the children will occur in patients with rheumatoid, systemic lupus, and rheumatoid arthritis, and gout. These are the four common conditions. But the moment you tell people, they say, well, will my child develop arthritis? Will my great-grandchild develop arthritis? Don't get into any fear. The Buddha said, live in the present. Just live in the present. Only a very minority, very, very insignificant minority develop arthritis from their parents. So just put that doubt and fear into rest. Put it now. Just say, my children will not develop arthritis. Absolutely. You should be negative. Negative can disturb the immune system and precipitate even arthritis. Stress can precipitate arthritis. Just be calm and blissful like the Buddha. Can I prevent developing arthritis? No, you cannot prevent developing inflammatory arthritis like rheumatoid or systemic lupus. You can't. One way to look at the Hindu way, you can probably say it is a karma to go through that process. Still now, they have not developed any vaccine to prevent development of rheumatoid arthritis or gout or anything like that. But one condition which you can prevent is a condition called osteoarthritis, which I shall tell you later. So prevent developing arthritis is not possible if you are destined to have an inflammatory arthritis, but normal body weight, normal BMI, nutritious food, adequate exercises, hitting stress by getting to yoga and pranayama, meditation, listening to soulful music, that's very important. And attempts to develop the self, that's very, very important. What is osteoarthritis? It is a condition where the knee joint gets burned out. And which age does osteoarthritis occur? It occurs invariably in the elderly age group. You see the lady towards the end, she's going around with a walking stick. And which joint is affected in osteoarthritis? Invariably, it's in the knees, or it can be in the fingers, or it can be in the hips. In India, it's most common in the knees, whereas in the Western world, it is more common in the hips. In India, osteoarthritis, that is wearing down of the knee joint, is absolutely common beyond the age of 50-55, especially when they are very obese. Is it a disabling disorder? Yes. People will not be able to climb up stairs. You see this woman, poor lady with osteoarthritis, she's not able to stand up even from sitting in a bench. And walking becomes very difficult. So osteoarthritis is a problematic problem. So what are the symptoms you develop? This occurs invariably at the age of 50-55. Till now, I have not developed osteoarthritis, but I have developed bone out of the hair on the scalp. I'm bald. But my cartilage can also become bald one day. I can walk with great disability. People have pain in the knee, difficulty in walking, standing for a long time in the kitchen, getting up from the squatting posture and climbing stairs. Mobility gets affected. See, one important thing you should remember. Life is mobility and mobility is life. If our mobility, what do we all tell everybody? Till the end, I want to be independent. I don't want to be dependent on anybody. When I was born, when I actually got conceived in my mother's womb, I never got an agreement, written agreement from God. Please write, Ramakrishnan will never be dependent on anybody. It's not possible to say. All of us can become dependent on somebody in life. The process of aging makes us dependent also. And osteoarthritis definitely can cause problems with restricted to mobility at all. How to diagnose? You have to see a doctor. He sees a clinical examination and he takes an X-ray of the joint which is affected. How do we treat? We treat them with mild painkillers like paracetamol. Invariably, we avoid anti-inflammatory drugs because most of them are elderly. I shouldn't say that. I'm also elderly. You can give topical ointments to relieve the pain. And lifestyle modification. This is very, very important, lifestyle modification. Please remember, if you're obese, reduce the body weight. You have to educate the patient. What are patients' do's and don'ts? Not to squat on the floor. What have you gained in this world by squatting on the floor? I don't think you gain anything. If you are fit, you can squat on the floor. You do whatever you want, high impact exercises. Once you develop osteoarthritis, no squatting on the floor, no skipping, no jogging, restriction of walking stairs. This is very important. And you can do exercises as taught with a physiotherapist. You can either have cold packs or you can have hot packs at home, which are all absolutely good house remedies available. This is the exercise we do. This is strengthening.